We are underway. Roberts knocked back to Billy Clifford. Billy Clifford will try an early diagonal ball towards Ben Winter. Tommy Wright rises above Winter, and Jake McCarthy can put the pressure on the Torquay back line early on, down by their own corner flag, kicking it away, but straight out of play, and Hamilton Waterlooville will have an early throwing after dumping that ball deep inside Torquay United territory.
They can give it back just as much, so that hopefully that's what happens.
Searle knocking it forward, looking for Tommy Wright. Joe Lewis has to win that one, loses out to Wright, drops to Jake McCarthy about 25 yards from goal. McCarthy into Roberts, just entering the penalty area, squared back across goal, but blocked by Ben Winter. Another Hamilton Waterlooville corner, make that four already.
Line.
The number 10 for the Hawks, again raises that left arm in the air, floated towards the head of Sean McDonald, flicked on, and into the bottom corner. Hamilton Waterlooville have the opening goal. It's Joe Osler, the captain, who celebrates in front of the home fans. Osler, a backwards header, looping over everyone, and nestling into the bottom corner. Hamilton Waterlooville 1, Torquay United 0. Off Clifford again, driving through the middle. He puts the goals on his back, spread out towards Joe Newton. Joe Newton, one-on-one with the fullback, touch round him. Back out to Billy Clifford. Clifford lining up room for a shot. Clifford does strike towards goal, straight into the chest of Sean McDonald, who does claim this one well. Charlie Searle, goalkeeper coming in for today's fixture after the injury of Ross Warner. His deep ball out to the left will find James Roberts, and Clifford can battle to win it back for the Hawks. Down the line it goes to Jake McCarthy. McCarthy's onside. He's got round Kiori Johnson. Into the box is McCoss, but he'd like room for a cross, but he does win a corner. Hawks will have another corner. Again, around their sixth of the game, Billy Clifford to take this one.
Yeah.
Remember, instead he'll spray this one towards Tommy Wright on the edge of the penalty area. Flicked out towards Oscar Goburn. Goburn will just play a 15-yard pass out to Josh Pasty, the right wing back. Pasty one-on-one with the fullback. Cross towards the box, just over Tommy Wright. And Joe Lewis had to take evasive action and clear that one behind. But just a little bit too much lift on that ball from Billy Clifford. I think he got the sand wedge out, Ryan. I think it needed the 9-iron.
Yeah, he was unlucky there. It was the right idea, the first time ball, but he didn't quite connect.
Oscar with putting the pressure by Dan Holman. Oscar lets it bounce, almost a nightmare moment between centre-back and goalkeeper. Oscar left it for Charlie Searle. Charlie Searle left it for Oscar. Holman almost benefited, but thankfully from a Hawks perspective, Searle able to dive on that one. Games played this year, just 3 wins, 2 draws and 6 losses. They've scored 16, they've conceded 22, and their top scorer by far is Armani Little with 5. Here's Goburn, good combination play up the left for Hamilton Waterlooville, to Roberts, out to Clifford. Clifford looking to chip it towards McCarthy, just out of reach of Jake McCarthy. Open the scoring for the Hawks, and they've really dominated since, except for the last 5 minutes, when Torquay United have grown into this game. Little, out to the left-hand side. Sent towards Little again, played into the penalty area. Torquay United driving forward, Searle spills, tapped in by Kiori Johnson, the early substitute, driven across the 6-yard box. Searle just couldn't get a strong enough hand to it, and Kiori Johnson taps home an equaliser for Torquay United in front of the travelling away fans. Your score, Hamilton Waterlooville 1, Torquay United 1. Back post, Manny Adewale just about gets his head on that one, ahead of Joe Lewis, back in the penalty area. Roberts will have work to do to clear this one away, bounced awkwardly in front of the forward, but clear it away he does, back on halfway with Ben Winter. Torquay United will keep this one alive, 43 minutes gone, score stands at 1-1. Dean Moxey on the left. Moxey, the left wing back. Another good cross. Lawless volleys home. The Greek forward has his revenge against the Hawks fans that gave him a hard time at the weekend. A flying volley from Lawless into the right corner. James Roberts can't get on it, but Hawks will have a throwing after a clearance by Dean Moxey. Pastley back to Roberts on the right wing. Under those floodlights here, and the half-time whistle goes. Hamilton Waterlooville dominated early. They took the lead through Joe Osler, but Torquay United got a vital foothold and a hook across towards the box to Jake McCarthy. Might drop to Tommy Wright, but pumped away by Joe Lewis out to the halfway line to Adebowale. Clifford. Hawks back on the ball and back with life in this game towards Roberts. Roberts on the edge. Roberts with his back to goal. He's trying to take on Ali Omar. Omar standing up well so far. Still going as Roberts towards the byline. Chip towards the back post. Tommy Wright would have got a toe on it, but Ben Winter just clipped it behind. A vital chance for the Hawks to maybe find their equaliser, but a vital touch from the former Palace man, Ben Winter. Getting up. One of the occasions the Hawks are thankful they play on a 4G pitch. McCarthy able to drop that one into the path of Wall. Alex Wall bearing down on the Torquay goal. Tommy Wright into the box. Wright, great save, McDonald. Tommy Wright just ran out of room and had to shoot from the angle. McDonald palms it away, or should I say thighs it away, spreading himself towards Tommy Wright. the thigh of Sean McDonald, who spread himself well. Cross comes in from Hamilton-Waterlooville towards Alex Wall, the large target man for the Hawks. Roberts on the edge, still driving forward. Here's Joe Oster. Oster tries a shot again, deflected behind. Another Hawks corner coming up. Here on Hawks Radio, the Hawks have done this before. They'll try and do it again. Dropped in towards Jake McCarthy. Oh my goodness, what a finish from Jake McCarthy. A fantastic volley. Whatever James Roberts can do, Jake McCarthy could do better. Not a good kick. We'll test Moxie. Tommy Wright able to get on it. Wright will give chase. Wright on side. Driving forward to the talking goal. Still Tommy Wright looks to go around McDonald. But McDonald spreads himself well, rushes at the feet of the forward and stops his progress. At four levels of the English football pyramid, formerly of Crystal Palace, Exeter, Derby and Bolton. Moxie chucks this one towards the near post. Flicked on by a goals player. Might drop at the edge. It was Wall that got it away, and Tommy Wright will get there first. Dan Martin clatters into him. Dan Martin's on a yellow card, I believe. They'll take a corner from the left-hand side, an in-swing on his right foot. Clifford towards Wall, headed in by Oster. No, parried away by McDonald. It looked destined for the back of the net. McDonald palming away on his own line. Here's Tommy Wright drifting in from the left. Wright onto his left foot, forces a shot, but was always going to have work to do, trying to bend that one round Joe Lewis.
In the open in the last 10, 15 minutes.
14 minutes left to play in this one. Matt Travell and Ryan Honey here on Hawks Radio. Hawks tied up at 2-2 with a man advantage. Wall will try and get around Winter. Wall's around Winter. It's Wall in the penalty area. Alex Wall tries a chip, but the offside flag is up initially against the striker anyway. And he immediately, after striking that ball, signals for a substitution. National to help out his fullback, Dean Moxie, and clear it away for a Hawks throw. Billy Clifford, down in the right-hand channel. He's being met by pressure from Dan Holman. Into Tommy Wright. Wright goes round Andrews, and Andrews will get just a yellow card, and really a very cynical challenge from Andrews, because if he hadn't hooked Tommy Wright down, Wright would have been away. The edge of the D, about 25 yards from goal, all told. Goburn's left foot will drift on towards the back post, headed on towards Rendell. Rendell not home! Hawks might have their winner. Scott Rendell, the substitute, nods past Sean McDonald and into the back of the net. Hawks fans celebrate. Hawks players celebrate. Top up your Oyster cards. The Hawks might be going to London. Oh, that's got to be about time. Referee says corner kick to Torquay United. The fans here are just waiting for their chance to erupt. An hour and 36 minutes played. Crossed in towards the near post. Well won by Joe Oster. He's been a warrior at the back. Full-time whistle goes in a game of peaks and valleys. The Hawks will be going to the valley. Chartered Athletic await. Hammond and Waterlooville 4, Torquay United 2. What a game, what a performance, what a tie that waits for the Hawks.